pay their respects. More vigils are planned in the area tonight and tomorrow. We got to a very sad state in our country where we immediately know what to do. On social networks, you take the town and you put it next to the word strong. Boulder strong, Boston strong, San Bernardino strong, Saugus strong. You know, it's just so sad that we know immediately what to do on social networks. And it just becomes the name of your town, place next to strong. Mm-hmm. And suddenly that's supposed to have great meaning for us. Regal Cinemas plans to reopen about 500 movie theaters around the country by the end of next week. That's going to include locations right here in Southern California. The theaters will be opening in time for the release of blockbusters like Godzilla vs. Kong. Yeah, Godzilla and Kong going at it. And Mortal Kombat. The first capacity limited to 25%, but in weeks it could increase to 50%. Are you ready to get back to the movies, to get into the theaters? Let us know, 31043, give us a text. According to new research, the average American spends 35 hours a year trapped in an internet wormhole. If you're not familiar with the term, it's when you search for one thing that leads to another. Before you know it, you've lost a portion of your day.
Yeah.
According to the survey, 4 to 5 people feel the availability of the internet at their fingertips gives them the urge to look up random information throughout the day.
Sure. Yeah.
Then, I did see a commercial for Alexa. I guess Google doesn't do it. I hope Google fixes it, because I'd like to have this feature on my little Google speaker at home. So, Alexa does whisper, like somebody was telling us the other day.
I tested it out.
Yeah. You see the dad, he's in some commercial, he goes, blank, blank. Tell me when the Civil War started. She whispers back and he goes to his kid, yeah, the Civil War started in, like he's all smart. And then the kid did a follow-up and he goes back like, all right, explain to me what happened at Gettysburg. Now he's whispering, Alexa's whispering it right back. I'm like,
yeah.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah.
So I tried it at home with Google and she goes, the Civil War started. I'm like, oh, shit. It's too much. 622, it's 104.3 My FM.
Rick, 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 R
Don't forget to do the fancy before that I told you. There.
Yeah.
Door, street, and iPhone. What is that in the front of the car? Door, street, and iPhone. Oh, fancy, street, and iPhone. I'm more watching this. What is that, Xtronic?
Oh, you're here.
What's racist? That's all great, too.
That's a choice, I mean, my life changes here. Oh, I'm trying.
Working.
104.3 MyFM, it is Valentine in the morning, 6:25. Good morning, everybody. Kevin, what are you up to?
I have an idea.
Maybe
like if somebody from Netflix is listening, they could take this and use this. I personally think that the sense of smell is like our most neglected sense. You know, people don't really cater to that much. Like, it's so powerful. You go outside and a breeze hits your nose and you're taken back to like a field trip in second grade. You know,
yeah. So.
Yeah. And Joe, what was that ride at Disney where they would pump in the smells?
Soaring Over California.
Right.
It has the orange spray.
Right.
Yes. While you're going over the orange groves or whatever.
Yes.
There's a museum. There's a Dutch museum that is now like offering scents to pair with their paintings, and they're not all good. Like 17th century art. And it's gonna smell like a canal on a hot summer day. It's
oh, gross. God. It's nasty.
Okay.
That's so gross.
Yes. I love it. I think it's awesome. I think more people need to do this. And this is my idea after I read that story.
Okay,
so you're watching Netflix, and then I would pay extra for this. Maybe you could buy like a candle. Like a quick burning candle for an episode of, let's say, Outlander, because that's what I'm watching right now. It's a period piece. As you're watching the episode, like quickly start, you light the candle at the beginning of the episode, and it releases the sense of the scenes.
You know, so it's really well.
It's going to smell awful. It's going to fill your house with a horrible sense.
Oh, not like the smell of the Battle of Culloden. Oh,
they're all slotting
guts and nasty people like, that haven't showered in years.
Would that ruin your perception of the Duke of Hastings, Joe, in Bridgerton? You could smell him?
I remember as a kid, there was a show, I want to say it was on Nickelodeon, I could be totally wrong, but we got cards. I don't know if it was in a box of cereal or what, but there were scratch and sniff. Six different scents on the card, and when we watched a certain show, don't remember what it was, scratch and sniff, and we saw the number come up on the screen.
Yeah.
So it would be something like that, and it corresponded with the show.
Here's what I would say. Let's take your thing one step further, because timing out that candle and stuff, it's not going to work. But what you could do, you've got sound bars, right? Like Roku and all those people, they all have like sound bars. Let's make a scent bar. So the scent bar is actually infused with all different scents, and they know the combination of scent A, B, C, D, all the way down the line. That would create, in that moment, in that scene, the scent of the canal that you're going through or whatever. It's a scent bar. It sits right down the bottom of your... Yeah, it really is doable. We've made $50 million, guys, right now.
We talked about this all the
time. Right, because that whole idea of a scent bar, that's something that really you could put together.
Good idea.
How fast can we get the artwork in that for a provisional patent? Yeah, okay. All right, I have patents, but I'm not going to be able to turn this one around that fast. I also, this whole time, was smelling this banana nut bread that's next to me. That's real. That's not a scent bar. Imagine, like, watching a cooking show, and they're using the scent bar. By the way, if y'all steal this, you suck. Because this is a real idea that we accidentally just came up with on the air. Jeez, God, guys, this could have been our big one, man.
The Food Network should take it. The Food Network, for sure. I would watch
anybody.
It every day.
First off, it's called The Scent Bar, and I just said that on the radio at 6:28, March 24th. So anytime after that, you're screwed, right? So this is all of us right here. Well, Brian didn't say anything.
Well, guess what? I just wrote it down and mailed it to myself, so you're all...
Well, you know how the post office works. You'll get that in 2 years. Do we include Jill in this, Kev? Because obviously with the scent bar thing, I got that from your idea, so we're both in on this thing.
Yeah, I think we, all four of us are in.
Really?
All
right.
See,
we haven't even
done anything, but he did nothing.
We just had this idea 30 seconds ago, and the money is already tearing us apart.
I can't take it.
Stay together.
I can't. No. Torn apart by this thing. It's kind of a brilliant idea.
It really is.
You know? Because, and I'll tell you why it would work, because you have companies like Peloton and all these different companies that control your bike speed or control your... You know, the thing going up and down in your treadmill. They do that. It's ingrained right in the program. If you're watching a taped bike session or if you're watching something live, they have little hit points in there. And same thing with the TV show. You could sync it up and have little hit points over the internet even. It doesn't even have to be with the TV show. You know, you could tell it what you're watching, time it out, and stuff like that. And over Wi-Fi, the internet, it would then control your scent bar. You need the multiple combinations, and you got to know the hit points in the show where you want those scents to come out.
Mm-hmm.
A scent bar is kind of freaking fantastic, and for a cooking show, it'd be deadly.
I can tell how excited you are about this idea now. You're like biting your nails in anticipation.
God, we've made billions of dollars. We're on Shark Tank with a scent bar next week. And by the way, our scent bar is also a sound bar, So it's a two for one, man. You also get the audio with that as well. Yeah.
Ooh, that's good.
And,
I love it.
And it's also a liquid bar, so it throws water at your face if there happens to be watching Water
World. It's raining.
It's raining. Yeah, it's raining. Watching Water World. Who's watching that? All right, we'll come back to this. If anybody steals it, you totally suck, and I'm really going to be mad at you. And would you buy it, though? 31043. Would you buy that? 31043. Let us know. We just came up with it. It's ours. I used to call. God, I was so rich. Sam Fisher, Demi Lovato, What Other People Say. Do you like the song? But now I'm on it, so I like it. Or would you rather hear this song, Sacrifice, be directed? Or this one we talked about just the other day, Ingrid Michaelson and Zayn, To Begin Again. It's okay, we will get another day. Which one grabs you? Which one do you want? What do you want to hear next? Text us 31043 and let us know which one's kind of grabbing you. So What Other People Say, Demi Lovato, Sam Fisher. I used to call my mom every Sunday. Phoebe Rexha, Sacrifice. To Begin Again, Ingrid Michaelson and Zayn. It's okay. Your choice, 31043. Brought to you by the Valentine in the Morning Scent Bar, under trademark and federal protection since 1984.
Valentine in the Morning.
Valentine in the Morning.
1043, my FM.
Whether you're ready for your COVID-19 vaccine or looking for the right testing options for your family, our Rouse team of healthcare providers is here to help. Our suite of solutions is one of the most comprehensive in the industry, trusted by frontline workers around the country. Visit Rouse.com/COVID care to learn more and schedule an appointment at a Rouse store near you.
Postmates is the best food delivery app in LA with all the city's best restaurants. We're giving new customers a special Postmates offer for $5 off your next 5 orders with code SNACK. Postmates is your personal food delivery, grocery delivery, whatever kind of delivery service all year round. They have all the best restaurants like Tokaya Organica, Howlin' Ray's, Sweet Fin, Alfred Coffee, and Fat Sal's. 24 hours a day, 365 days a year, Postmates will bring you what you need within the hour. Download the app for iOS or Android for free and use code SNACK for $5 off your next 5 orders.
Did you know that your local grocery outlet is independently owned and operated by folks in your community? Unlike traditional grocery stores, this allows us to better serve our customers and the communities in which we operate. We support local schools and charities like helping fire departments with toy drives. We also donate thousands of items each year to food pantries in your neighborhood. Stop by your local grocery outlet today and see what we've been up to.
It's exciting, it's exhilarating, and now it's electrified. Introducing the first fully electric Porsche Taycan. Experience the most advanced driving technology a sports car has to offer. 0 to 60 in as fast as 2.6 seconds. Accelerating faster than the...